Hello, gamers and gamesters on the internet. I'm back, and for this video I'll show you my first unboxing. It is a figure from the company Vertex, and it is also a gaming figure. You'll probably know it if you are into fighters. And it is Noel Vermillion. This is from series BlazBlue. This is a figure from their latest game, Chrono Phantasma. And it is not, well, the game itself is not available in the West yet. It has been available since last October, I think, in Japan. And it will be released on March 25th in America. I have never lived in Europe, so I have no idea when the game will hit here. This is the box, as you can see, and I will be opening up it up for you. So let's have a look. There we go, all wrapped in plastic as usual with these kind of figures. Let's just remove the box here. First up, we have of course the disc, where you have to place a figure on. Noel Vermillion does stand on 1 foot, and as you can see, you will have to place it only here. It is strong, however, so I don't think it will be a problem. Hopefully the weight will not lean her over too much. Other than that, the base is all decorated with, well, fragments and other decorations from the main series. In BlazBlue Chrono Phantasma, Noel Vermillion has changed just a little bit. Let's just wrap this up around here as well. There we go. Everything is, all the plastic is gone, I assume. Yep. Let's just have a closer look at her. And Chrono Phantasma is the first time that her hair is loose. Before that, in BlazBlue Continuum Shift, she wore a beret, which covered all her hair. But now it is loose, so you can actually see how long it is. Other than that, she does wield her guns. What was that name again? The Nox Nictoris Arcus Diabolus. Oh damn, what a freaking name of that is. You can see that this is very loose. She does seem to look fairly slim, but if you do look at her face, she looks adorable, but I must say that, well, she does look like a fighter as well. Which is obvious because she does rock in BlazBlue. She's one of my favorite characters. And it is just, well, her feet. This is the only part that will be on the base. It does also feel very sturdy. So I don't think this will break fairly easy. Thank God for that. She also has her cape. This is the cape that you can remove if you wish to. I will not remove it because I like it. Let's just place it on her again. And there you have it. Her cape is on. And I do like it a little bit more now. Some might say that she is a little bit too edgy, or, well, sexy posts, especially if you look at her, well, you know what I mean. Seriously, you know what I mean. But other than that, I do think her finish is really, really decent. Let's just place her on the base here. There we go. Now she stands firmly on the base and I can wobble her. Nope, nothing happening, nothing's changing. And, well, this is it. This is Noel Vermilion from BlazBlue Chrono Phantasma. After checking the box, there is one more thing that I can add to this figure, which are the holsters of her guns, as she is wielding it right now on her left hand. There are also these, well, lints, or I have no idea what they are called, but these are just to add some flair to the figure. You do not have to adjust them, of course. I can also remove them, as you can see. But I'm not really sure yet whether I will be keeping them on or not. I like it more with only the holster. But other than that, well, this is Noel Vermilion from BlazBlue Chrono Phantasma. Thank you for watching. This was also my first unboxing video. I will be doing more in the future and also have a look at some art books. And if you have any suggestions on to make something better here, then please do say so in the comments below. Thank you for watching and have a good evening.